This video is to demonstrate how to upload programming assignments in Moodle with help of virtual programming lab plugin. So once a faculty upload problem statements in Moodle, the VPL plugin will take care of evaluating submissions submitted by the students. A faculty need not evaluate those submissions. So what you need for every program, what you need to submit for every problem. There are only two things you need to submit. The first one is a problem statement, which describes what a student is supposed to do to pass this problem statement. And set of test cases. A test case is nothing but what is your program expecting as an input, and what is the output for respective input. This is one test case, and this is another test case. Input followed by output. So you have to make sure that you are giving at least 5 test cases. Here, for demonstration purpose, I'm giving only 2 test cases. Make sure that you give at least 5 test cases so that students will not try any other means of more practice by printing the output in printf statements. And one more thing you have to remember is don't give prompting statements in the input section. That means don't give like an entire number of vertices, entire number of edges. So don't give any such kind of prompting statements. That is one important thing. So that's it. You need only 2 things. One is a problem statement, and another one is test cases, a set of test cases. Here I'm taking 2 test cases. Now let's get into the Moodle. Once you log into your Moodle account, in the top right corner, you can find a settings button. Click turn editing on so that you can add any number of activities, you can modify activities. So my course is already having 4 topics. If you want, you can add one more topic by clicking this add topics button, or you can add activities to already existing topics anywhere. So wherever you want, you just click add an activity or resource button and choose the virtual programming lab kind of activity and click add button. Here, give your problem name. Here, give your complete description of your problem. And also provide some sample test cases. How the input is going to be, and what is the expected output for that corresponding input. This input and this is the expected output. Now, look into the settings. The submission period. So from when you would like to, from when this submission is supposed to open and when it is supposed to close. Okay, give your submission deviation as per your assignment. And you have to be careful with this one, submission restriction. Click show more button. Here you can find some interesting things. A student can, if you want to let student to upload their files, they can upload. This is the maximum number of files you are allowing the student to upload. If you want, you can disable this one also. If you want to disable a file upload or copy paste from somewhere else, just make it as yes. Disable external file upload and drop external content. And you don't need this one because you disable file upload. And here, if you want, you can set the password so that the student can able to write these submissions only after revealing the password. And this one, you need all these things. So when you are working with safe exam browser. Now, for now, we are not using this. Go to restrict access. So So there's a place where you can restrict set of students. For example, if you are if you have some 10 to 20 sections, if you want to enable this only for one or two sections, you can do that by clicking add restriction. We already created set of groups. Okay, we have around more than 10 groups we have. So click the group button and select the group. So we have this many number of groups. If you want to add one more section, again click add restriction, group. If you want to add one more section, that means this activity, this VPL activity is only visible to group A, group B, group C. That's it. Click save on display button. So far what we did, we did some set, we take care of settings as well as we have defined our problem statement. Now let's upload the test cases. You have to upload the test case separately. Here, click on the settings button. You can find test cases. Here you copy and paste your test cases. So I have two test cases. Copy and paste test case. So this is test case one, whose input is this one, and this is the corresponding output. This is test case two, and the input of test case two, and the corresponding output of test case two. Like that, you can add n number of test cases. Save this, zoom out. Now we are done. Okay, that's it. That is from the faculty side. You just have to give problem statement, and you have to upload the test cases. That is done. So before giving it to the students, first let us verify whether it is working properly or not. So here it is. This is what I created just now. Finding degree is my VPL assignment. Now see, as we restricted only for three groups, so it is available only for you belong to A, B, and C. Verify once. We restricted it, and make sure that you change this one from all to any. Then only this activity is available if a student belongs to either group A or group B or group C. If it is all, the student is supposed to belong to all three groups. So don't forget to change it as any of the following groups. See? Not available unless you belongs to any of A, B, and C groups. So let's verify. Before giving to the students, you just have to verify it. Okay. Go to test activity and copy your file name, hello.cpp. Copy your code for checking. Copy your program for checking, save your program, and do your evaluation. So, okay. There are two buttons. One is run button and one is evaluate button. Run is only for testing, and evaluate means it will evaluate with your pre-uploaded test cases, and it will automatically submit if you click evaluate button. Let's evaluate this. See here, all the test cases are passed. We have given only two test cases. Two test cases are passed. That's it. This is how you can upload, how you can give VPL assignments in the Moodle.